We create these trouble spots. This is our game. We arm people to the teeth, and then we go bomb them and sell them new armament again and build their cities. These are like Halliburton and Union Carbide and all these, the ownership class in this country. This country is owned by 800 or 900 people who run everything, do everything, control everything. They had this guy. Clinton gets in, fine, we can deal with him. Kerry gets in, fine, we can deal with him. It's just in the wind. It's a little reed like this. It's all one big ownership class, and they,
the genius of Leslie Nielsen. And he made this movie, Naked Gun 2.5, to be able to uncover some of the problems that the evil ultra-rich were doing to the environment. And now it's 30-plus years after, and the problems are not getting handled. So I had to make this movie to kind of give you an idea. 30 years ago, we had this message, and we didn't do anything because of the evil ultra-rich.
Mr. President, tonight I am extremely proud to welcome our guests from the nation's energy suppliers. First, representing the oil industry, head of the Society of Petroleum Industry Leaders, better known as SPIL, Mr. Terrence Baggett.
That massive oil slick now covering some 600 square miles of the Gulf of Mexico, and it could start reaching the United States coast within hours.
The spills from the oil companies are just incredible. Not just this one. This is just a description of one spill. It's just amazing the damage done to our environment, our society, by this evil, ultra-rich big oil that puts money and profit over people. We got these messages a long, long, long time ago, and these people just don't give up. They don't let go. We know that we could farm our fuel and grow it. Could get oil from plants, and the plants will take in the carbon dioxide and let out oxygen, but we just won't do it because the guy who owns the drill and owns the pipeline and owns the tanker doesn't want us to. It is time for the human race to really just get to the point and don't put our future, our children's future, our children's children's future in jeopardy just because of oil. Time for us to do something. There's even more problems with the evil ultra-rich.
From the coal industry, chairman of the Society for More Coal Energy, or SMOKE, Mr. Donald Fenswick.
Thank you.
The air pollution is extreme. We've jeopardized our future, jeopardized the future of humanity, destroyed by these fossil fuels. We have to be able to do something. We have to look at the future differently.
Thank you very much. And from the nuclear industry, president of the Key Atomic Benefits Office of Mankind, kaboom, Mr. Arthur Dunwell.
Yeah, kaboom, and the nuclear accident that happened in Japan has filled the ocean with radioactive waste, jeopardizing the future of humanity. We have to do something about this evil ultra-rich.
Mr. President,
I want all of you here to be the first to know that I've decided to base my administration's entire energy policy on Dr. Meinheimer's recommendations. Now, this issue is too important to be left to politicians. I'm pleased to say that we're graced with the presence of so many distinguished guests tonight.
Just a minute, buddy. Don't you know this is a Cuban cigar? With the money you paid for this, you just bought one bullet for Castro.
Rather, we need an independent and informed source on which to base our future actions, and Dr. Meinheimer is the recognized expert in this field.
Mr. President, if I may say so, I do hope that Dr. Meinheimer won't be influenced.
I've made a lifetime out of trying to expose the evil ultra-rich and the damages that they represent to the future. Nobody listens.
Influenced by any of the so-called environmental groups?
Well, we're all well aware of Dr. Meinheimer's reputation, so I think that perhaps he's best qualified to explain his research methods.
Oh!
Dr. Meinheimer.
Where's Lady
Donovan?
We at Chevron believe that nothing is more precious than life, and that the most precious life of all is the dead kind that has been compressed for hundreds of millions of years under massive rocks until it magically becomes oil. Oil that we can refine and sell as gasoline.
True media doesn't tell you. No, the whole point of a for-profit public corporation is maximize profit, and we don't give a damn about you. So any talk of like companies being patriotic, if you hear someone saying that, understand they know nothing about politics or capitalism or the economy at all.
Because at the end of the day, we at Chevron straight up don't give a single about you, your weird children, or your stupid ratty ass dog. And we have billions and billions of dollars to pay for this commercial time, this cheesy footage, and this bull music. All so that you will be lulled into a catatonic state that makes you forget one singular fact. Chevron is actively murdering you every day.
Companies are not human beings. They don't have feelings. They can't be patriotic. The only thing they are is profit maximizing machines. So of course they don't care about you. And in the, when you're in the oil business, you maximize profit at the expense of the rest of us.
See, the human brain can only deal with so many things at once. So these emotionally loaded scenes will always push aside other thoughts like, Chevron is murdering me. It's just how our brains work. You meat puppet who exists only to feed us profits. Chevron, it's hard to even comprehend how little of a we give about you.
Yes, we must, as a race of humanity, gather together and recognize that we have to do something. I tried to make this funny. I've made the message in so different, many different ways. So I'm making it funny today to help to get across the message.
Until tonight, then. Well, I think we have enough information for today. I see that you're very busy here.
Corporations are not really human. And they think only of themselves. The people inside the corporation have jobs, and the jobs are to make more money. If you don't make more money, you lose your job. So corporations are by nature psychopathic.
It looks like you have more pressing things to attend to this afternoon, so I'll just be on my way.
Where's your hat, Frank?
I dropped it off back there. Well, let's keep in touch, Dr. Weinheimer.
Frank?
I won't be bothering you anymore. I hope you're happy.
Our planet is blue, and I mean sad, not just blue in color, but our planet is sad because we are killing the planet.
Hey, I like it. You know, someday, way in the future, the sun may be able to provide all our energy needs. But right now, it gives us a comfortable feeling to know that our home is being supplied by nuclear power.
Yeah, we see what nuclear power did for Japan. We really can't contain this waste effectively and perfectly. It puts us all at risk.
Oh, I know what you're thinking, but we're not worried because we know that nuclear energy is safe. In fact, we kind of think of it as our friendly neighbor. But remember, our friend can't exist without huge government subsidies. So write your congressman and tell him to keep those government dollars rolling into nuclear power.
Well, if we talk about failures, I think that we need to look at what's happening today to some of the failures.
So I have given up, I've thrown in the towel, I've taken all the
Biden's no different. Basically, we need to look past this and start recognizing democracy ultimately doesn't work in a stupid population.
I thought you two were so good together. Of course, I thought you and Rosalind were great, too. Marcia, Lily, Diane, and of course, Shu Li and Ting Li.
The Siamese twin, moonlit nights we used to go for a walk, hand in hand in hand in hand.
Go to a Frank.
This is not easy to say.
I'm lonely, I'm lost, I need someone to hold, to love.
Frank. Over here.
Well.
I know about how the FDA works. I was a victim of one of their FDA raids way back there in the 80s and 90s. They really attacked alternative medicine. So some of these stories about the FDA attacking natural medicine, they were true. We hope that we'd stop them in the future.
Got it. It's only vitamins. Vitamin C, you know, like in oranges.
Sam, play our song. Just one more time.
Of course.
That's enough.
Gentlemen, I know you're all worried, and I agree. There's plenty to be worried about, like this solar power plant, already operational outside Los Angeles.
Yes, we got these messages 100 years ago, 50 years ago, and then 30 years ago, we got the big giant message what the evil ultra-rich was doing and how they were hurting us. And we still just don't take back control from these people.
Photovoltaic cells. They convert sunlight directly into electricity. Fluorescent lasts 10 times as long as a conventional light bulb, uses only a quarter of the power. Super windows insulate as well as 10 sheets of glass.
The fact that what they can do in lobbying at the government, it just goes on and on. As the money and power talks, and that there is close to $40 trillion missing from the Pentagon. Oh my God.
Hexagon Oil Commercial number one.
Piloting today's giant oil tankers is a big responsibility. And that's why here at Hexagon's Tanker Captain Training School, future captains go through a rigorous instruction program. Then, through a complicated elimination process, we weed out those less qualified for the day-to-day operation of a 500,000-ton single-hulled supertanker. Only the best will be allowed to take command of what is essentially a floating ecological time bomb.
Commercial two.
Just the way.
Lieutenant Frank Driven, police squad, this is my captain, Ed Hockham.
Is this some kind of bus?
Secret agent man, they've
A secret agent man, secret agent man. They've given you a number and taken away your name. Secret agent man, secret agent man. They've given you a number and taken away your name.
An electric car, partially powered by solar panels.
But the truth is, gentlemen, I'm not worried about any of these things. Because no one's ever going to know about them. What
about... So can't you people listen to what's being said here today? And can't we open our hearts and our minds to really not just get laws, but to get an entire idea across. Money is not God.
Not one of you pigs.
Just take it easy, man.
Say your prayer.
Nice work, Frank.
What?
Ted, can you show us those lab results you got back from the Research Institute?
We weren't able to get any clean fingerprints, Captain.
We start looking at karma, good karma, and how we as a human race could stop putting our value in just money and go beyond that and recognize the future of humanity is a very valuable commodity. We are devastating the planet as we make more and more carbon dioxide, and we have a system of taking oil that produces more carbon dioxide. No step in the process of drilling for oil or transporting it, no step actually destroys the carbon dioxide and gives oxygen. Every step of the process takes in oxygen and gives off carbon dioxide. We could grow our oil. We could grow it. And then the plants will be taking in and washing away that carbon dioxide and giving us a cleaner fuel. The reason the fuel is dirty is because it comes from the ground. Plants would give us a cleaner fuel. We would be able to save the planet. But the guy who owns the tanker, the refinery, the drill, he doesn't really want us to save the planet. He worries about his money.
Woke up this morning, opened my eyes. There's something special on my mind. Started thinking about the ultra rich. I knew that they could. Oh yeah. Something tells me the ultra rich is up to no good. Ultra rich wants us all to fail. And they're gonna make sure they ruin our day. I started thinking about the ultra-rich and knew that they would. Something tells me the ultra-rich is up to no good. Got it thinking what they're gonna do. And I tell you it's gonna be me and you. They steal from us every day. Try to think how to make us pay. Dr. Rich, they stack it to us all, and they make us all fall. Something I knew the ultra-rich could. Something tells me the ultra-rich is up to no good. Something tells me the ultra-rich is up to no good. I don't know what to tell you. Start to wake up and to feel wrong. Gotta tell you all today what they think today. tenderly than one night stand. I think the ultra rich is up to no good. The ultra rich will stick us every way that they could. Something tells me the ultra rich is up to no good. Something tells me the ultra rich is up to no good. Everything tells me the ultra rich is up to no good.
We've made this planet a toxic sewer of garbage and plastic. We've ruined the air and the water. It's time to clean up. It's time to recognize. We need to put people before profit, not profit before people. We all saw these messages way back then. We've all known the difficulty about what taking away the resources of the planet, putting profit over people, how it could put us all in jeopardy. But we haven't really done enough, if anything.
I need some french fries and all the fry oil you can lay on me.
So what is this mystery solution?
That right there, it's the end of the gas conspiracy.
It's used cooking oil, the leftover gunk at the bottom of deep fat fryers. And believe it or not, this may be the next big thing.
I think that's it.
To put it to the test, they're going to drive a circuit in a diesel car which has their viewable fuel tank attached.
We've been hearing that people are running their cars completely without any modifications on used vegetable oil, like this.
But before experimenting with the oil, they first need to test regular diesel to find the car's normal fuel consumption.
Hold on. You're pretty much exactly at a liter, so give it a tiny bit more. Up. That's perfect. Exactly right.
Okay. Diesel. First run.
All right.
Ready.
Go.
The course is 4.7 kilometers long and has been designed so that they can maintain a steady 35 miles an hour all the way round.
What was the mileage on that?
8.8.
8.8, okay. 15 minutes and 15 seconds. 33 and a third miles to the gallon on straight diesel.
With the baseline sussed, next up is the used cooking oil.
Ah, look at that. Pure power.
Pure power, it may be, but will the car even start? The engine is purring perfectly. They're off. Remember, this is unmodified chip oil, the stuff that restaurants everywhere chuck out.
This seems to be running just fine.
They do the laps and get a mileage almost identical to the diesel, which for free fuel is impressive.
Number one, I'm surprised and impressed that the car runs on just straight filtered used kitchen oil. But number two, the fuel efficiency, it's only 10% less than, you know, regular diesel fuel.
Yeah, that's cool.
The other thing is we didn't make any modifications to this car. That means anybody who had a diesel car could just pour the stuff straight into the gas tank and it would run fine.
Woo! Yeah, baby!
All of the world's petroleum comes from algae that lived and died in shallow oceans eons ago. On the left, I have three samples of algae oil that were extracted from chips that you see in the foreground. On the right, there's jatropha oil that was extracted about 12 hours ago from seeds like the ones you see in the foreground. There's enough land in this area to grow all of the fuel to support the fuel needs of the United States.
Tropical climes are certain times of day when all the citizens retire to tear off their clothes and perspire. It's one of those rules that the greatest fools obey, because the sun is much too sultry and we must unfold this ultraviolet rays. Oh, yes. Natives grieve when the white men leave their huts, because they know that they're all fucking goddamn nuts. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The Japanese don't care to, the Chinese wouldn't dare to. Hindus and Argentines sleep early from 12 to 1. But the Englishmen detest a siesta. In the Philippines, there are lovely screens to protect you from the glare. To the Valley States, where the hats are plates, the British ones won't wear. At 12 noon, the natives swoon, and no work is done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the fucking sun!
He's mowing like a man possessed! Vegetable oil is used to make biodiesel for cars using a complex industrial process called transesterification. The brainiacs prepared their oil using a process called frying. And it seems to be working as the mower approaches the finish line, and with it, an end to the global fuel crisis. Yes, he made it. Oh, the sweet smell of victory, which in this case smells a bit like chip shops.
It's such a surprise for the Eastern eyes to see that though the English are defeat, they're impervious to the heat. When a white man rides and the natives hide in glee, because the simple creatures hope he will impale his toupee on a tree. Oh, yes. Diddy-diddy-daddy. It seems such a shame that the English claim the earth, that they give rise to such a levity and mirth. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The toughest Burmese bandits can never understand it. In Rangoon, the heat of noon, he sees the natives shun. They put their scotch and rye down and lie down. In a jungle town with sunbeams down and the rage of the beast, the English guard, the English sahib, merely just gets more creased. In Bangkok at the 12 o'clock, they foam at the mouth and run. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the fucking goddamn midday sun. The smartest Malay rabbit deplores this stupid habit. In Hong Kong, they strike a gong and they fire off a noonday gun to reprimand each inmate who's in there. In the mango swamps where the python runs, there's peace from 12 to 2. And even caribous lie around and snooze and nothing else to do. In Bangkok, they move it. Oh, it's seldom ever done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday. Out in the midday, out in the midday, out in the midday. They go out in the midday, they go out in the midday. Fucking
there's a reason, there's a reason. There's a reason for this. There's a reason education sucked, because the owners of this country don't want that. I'm talking about the real owners now. The big, the wealthy, that the real owners, the big wealthy business interests that control things and make all the important decisions. Forget the politicians. They're irrelevant. The politicians are put there to give you the idea that you have freedom of choice. You don't. You have no choice. You have owners. They own you. They got you by the balls. They spend billions of dollars every year lobbying to get what they want. Well, we know what they want. They want more for themselves and less for everybody else. But I'll tell you what they don't want. They don't want a population of citizens capable of critical thinking. They don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. They're not interested in that. That doesn't help them. That's against their interest.
We can grow our oil. We do not have to dig for it. We do not have to drill for it. When we grow the oil, the plants will take in the carbon dioxide, clean out that carbon dioxide, and give us oxygen to save the planet. So I hope my little movie today has touched your hearts and your minds, and I hope that you can start to recognize that we need to do something, that we need to really get pressure on to the evil ultra-rich companies and find a way to save our planet and save humanity. This is Desiree DuVernay. Hope I touched your hearts and I gave you a little grin.